Coming up, we give you a roundup of the latest infusion of artificial intelligence in Office. To find relevant content expertise as you search for information and author in Office, up-level your presentations and documents through automated design assistance in PowerPoint and the integration of mixed reality, uncover hidden insights in your data, focus your inbox and use Cortana at work to manage your calendar, and even use AI to proactively protect yourself and your data at work. I'm joined once again by Jack Elmore. Welcome back.
Good to be back, Jeremy. Thanks.
So AI is really infusing everything, everything from our devices at home and things in our car and the office. And we've been infusing AI really in our applications at Microsoft for a while now under the covers.
Yeah, Office has been focused on intelligent features for 20 plus years. And so what's exciting is AI and the cloud-powered capabilities start to really unlock creativity, reason over large amounts of data, and do some fantastic things that come alongside your work, help you create professional results without getting in the way.
All right, so let's make this real for the people watching at home. What can we do now as an everyday Office user?
Well, I've got a couple scenarios that I'll show you today, Jeremy. First, I'm gonna start with, my resume.
Okay.
As you know, I'm looking for my next opportunity here. And so I'm gonna pull up my resume, and what do you notice on the right-hand side? There's the resume assistant coming up.
So AI has detected that the resume is a resume file and opened that up?
It's done more than that. Detected that it's a resume and that the name matches the username. So it's mine.
Mm-hmm.
It knows that this is, I'm not looking at someone else's, but this is my resume. And so it's actually captured my job title here, and you'll notice some of Word's cloud-powered editored features, like, for example, think outside the box. It's suggesting, you know, maybe I should use think freely instead of saying young blood. Maybe I should. So it's helping me to improve my writing style. That extends beyond just resumes.
Right.
But the resume assistant is actually sorting out some similar resumes. Now, LinkedIn has profiles on over 500 million people. So it can start to use AI to say, you know what? Here are some resumes and ways that others have described their work experience similar to yours.
Okay.
A lot of people suffer from blank page syndrome when they start working on a resume. It's not something that we do every day. Right.
These will really help people get started.
Yeah, so as I click into these and I say, hey, I want to see some more examples, I can filter those examples by different related disciplines. As I scroll down, I get some ideas like, hey, you could see additional examples on LinkedIn. And then if I want to get really creative, I could say, you know what, I want to hire a professional to do this. Frankly, I just kind of want somebody else to take care mm-hmm. of it for me. So there's a lot of great information that's available here right inside Microsoft Word. But as I scroll down a little bit further, what I can start to see is something really interesting around skills. So LinkedIn tracks a lot of great information around job postings and the way that the winning job applicants are describing their skills and then translating that to titles. So here we can start to say, these are some skills that I might have, but I might not have described them in a way that's going to generate the most hits and create the most matches. So this is helping my resume to get seen. Articles on writing your resume and even suggested jobs. So here in Seattle, we've got Starbucks, we've got, you know, Amazon, Time, Inc. A lot of folks have got job postings, and I can even with a single click let recruiters know that I'm actually looking for that next opportunity. So whether you're brushing up your resume for your next job internally or looking for your next opportunity outside the organization, Microsoft Word has a lot to do to help you publish your resume in a way that's going to be exciting and engaging using the power of AI.
Right, and really what's happening here behind the scenes is we're taking some of the things like search APIs and cognitive services, we're doing the lookups against the information that's in LinkedIn, and then serving up those results. So you're able to really get some things that really match what you're trying to do in the resume assistant. And the nice thing is when I open up my resume, it's just going to just directly detect its resume. And if I don't find that, and maybe I'm starting from scratch, I can get straight to that through the, which tab was it?
So under review, you'll see the resume assistant here on the far right.
Right.
And that feature can be turned on right under file options. Show LinkedIn features in my Office applications.
So you can get it running right from there, even if you start from scratch. So now let's say you've landed your job, you're on the next journey,
yeah.
The next chapter of your life. Now, how do I stay in the job once I've got it?
Yeah, that's right, Jeremy. So you've landed your role, and you'll notice I'm using Teams as my hub for teamwork. Now, the great thing about this is I can go back in time as the newest person joining the team.
Right.
I can see the relevant chats and conversations and get caught up. I don't have to have people send me a bunch of prior emails.
Right.
So I can get connected to exactly what's going on. I want to show you one example here with Microsoft Stream. Now, this is like a corporate YouTube where you can mm-hmm. publish videos. But it has some really unique capabilities. Here's an example of the quarterly state of Contoso. So this is the CEO addressing the company. I'm going to click in and see what Patty Fernandez had to say at the last company all hands.
Okay.
So here I can consume this all hands right from within Teams. But if I activate the full Microsoft Stream experience, you're going to start to see some additional capabilities that are fueled by AI. Let me show you a couple of those. Here's Patty. She's going to begin speaking in a moment. And as I scroll down, do you see here three different people? So it's actually sorting out that like different people are speaking during this video.
Mm-hmm.
AI is determining who those unique speakers are and where they're speaking inside the video itself. So I can use that as a navigational element. More importantly, I can filter this relatively lengthy CEO address and say, hey, I got hired to work on the Mark 8 quadcopter. So I really just want to kind of see what Patty has to say about the Mark 8. And when I type Mark 8, that transcript is generated automatically from the spoken text and shows me at 7 minutes and 43 seconds. That's
and
where
it's
she.
Quite cool because it actually, you did a search for the letter 8 and it actually found the spelled out version of 8. So it's actually done some fuzzy matching there as it transcribed the voice to text. So
pretty intelligent.
Really what we're seeing here from an intelligence standpoint is we're seeing computer vision. So it's detecting the speaker and who's actually talking and letting you jump between those different speakers we saw with the heads earlier and the different parts of the video. It's also transcribing the video from voice to text. And then based on that text that's been transcribed, it's enabling these search capabilities that Jack just showed by looking for Mark 8.
That's exactly right.
All right, so you're back in Teams now and I know you're working on Mark 8. What else have you got going?
So we've got a crew working around the clock as the sun, you know, goes, so goes the work around the world.
Mm-hmm.
And so a team in France here is working on a presentation about the latest capabilities and status on the Mark 8. So I'm going to pull up that presentation. Now, the first thing I got to do though is translate it to a language that I can understand. I don't know how to consume French, but with PowerPoint's cloud-powered translator, I can simply translate these slides from French to English, and in a matter of seconds, I've got that same presentation now translated using cognitive services from French to English.
Nice.
I'm going to take these four pictures here of our Mark 8, and in just a moment, the cloud-powered designer pops up and says, you know what, here are some alternate examples or ways that you could lay out that slide. That's pretty nice looking, right?
It's not bad.
Better than what we had before.
A few other recommendations you can make there, but this looks really good.
Yep. So I'm going to move on to the next slide, and here you see that this very wide-angle photo, clearly you need to focus on the woman there just to the left of center. And with salient region detection, this is happening automatically, intelligent cropping of the photo to make this woman the hero of the slide. As we move further, we've got our development milestones and when we plan to launch. You can see November of this year. And I can very quickly turn that into an intelligent piece of smart art. Now, because this is just smart art, I can visualize this information in a number of different ways, including one of my favorites, the arrow pointing toward the upper left. So I'm starting to look pretty good. Yeah, Jeremy?
Much better so far. Yep.
And then finally, for a slide like this that has a series of call to action steps that are prepended by a verb, I can represent that as a numbered list, or I can even go further down and call out that specific verb to draw attention to the action that I'm asking for.
Very cool stuff. So we saw you translate from French to English earlier. Is there anything else we can do there?
Well, I mentioned we're a global organization, and so we've got a group in Asia that we're going to present this content to, and I understand you may speak a little bit of Chinese. All right.
So
what we're going to do is take advantage of the other natural language capability powered by cognitive services, and we're going to subtitle our presentation as you present it. So if you'd kindly put on your headset.
All right, let's see if this works the other way around.
You're going to speak simplified Chinese, and we're going to subtitle it in English.
I'm going to try to speak simplified Chinese.
It's going to be fantastic. Okay, so before we get started, here you can see a QR code, and if you have the Microsoft Translator app on your phone, you can actually choose from a library of over 60 languages that you speak and have real-time simultaneous subtitling, consume it on your phone in, for example, Portuguese or some other language as well. So what I'm going to do now is begin the slide presentation, and I'll go off mute, and you can begin speaking.
朋友们,你好,谢谢,今天是未来。
How about that? Pretty accurate?
Not bad. That's exactly what I was trying to say.
Fantastic. So what you can see here is in the global organizations of today and of tomorrow, look at all of the powerful ways that we can communicate and keep that cycle going across the time zones, across the world, across languages.
Very cool. So we just saw a lot of intelligence being applied within the context of PowerPoint. But I know you're working on some other things in terms of being able to work with mixed reality also. So what can we do there?
So I've shown you an example of like an internal status update presentation, right?
Mm-hmm.
What I really want to be able to do is generate excitement and demand for my Mark 8 before it's actually even available in the market. I'd like to sell some pre-orders.
Okay.
So I've got an example here of a two-customer presentation. And you know, we've been able to insert pictures inside of PowerPoints for many, many years. But what is new is this ability to add 3D models. So I've got a 3D model here of my quadcopter. And you can kind of see I can rotate that there. I've got a variety of different ways I've positioned that same image across mm-hmm. multiple slides to call attention to different features.
And the nice thing is, if you're using PowerPoint now, you can test that by using 3D images, even if you don't have things handy, just by going through and finding those through the kind of the Remix archive.
That's exactly right. So yeah, for example, if I went up here to 3D models and I said I want to pull from online sources, you'll see a series of very much like the online pictures gallery right. as well. You can search for something that you're looking for.
But we can actually do some pretty cool things. We've shown Morph in the past with 2D images.
Yep.
We can do that here with the 3D as well, right?
Right. So the Morph transition automatically calculates differences between slides. And what I'm going to do here is take a copy of this quadcopter image and simply paste it on slide 2. But I'm going to make some adjustments. Maybe I'm going to rotate it a little bit and move it down here into the lower right. To talk about the long-range control.
Mm-hmm.
And then as I animate my presentation with the morph transition, watch what happens. I automatically calculate the differences between the slides in a cinematic movie-like effect.
That looks amazing.
So when you combine that morph transition with all of the other animations that are in PowerPoint, anybody can create a presentation that looks like this, incredibly professional. Yes, would you agree?
Very cool. So you've shown now with Designer, showing how you can make those other slides go from kind of zero to hero in that case. We've shown it now with Morph and the 3D images. But I know you can do a bit more in terms of mixed reality and what's built in with Windows 10.
Yeah, there's nothing like you seeing it in the real world to create a sense of realism and also to grab your checkbook and buy that first one that's coming off the
right,
assembly
right.
line.
I'd love to have a drone myself.
That's right. So here I've got that same 3D quadcopter model inside Windows 10 with mm-hmm. mixed reality. Now, at the moment, okay. I'm just viewing the model, and of course I can look at it from a variety of different perspectives, the same types of things we observe there in PowerPoint. But if I take this Surface device and I hold it here and I'll just point at the table and tap the mixed reality button, in just a moment what you're going to see is we actually detect that there's a hard surface there, and I can drop that quadcopter right here into real space, adjust it, and you'll notice as I rotate the Surface device, it stays pinned in space. And I can even take a picture and then email that picture to you to make sure that you're as excited as I am about purchasing one of these quadcopters.
All right, that looks amazing. Yeah, I'd love to have that here in the studio. So
yep.
Very cool. So we saw how PowerPoint and kind of the office experience gets much better. A lot of people, though, when they think about AI and they think about using intelligence, they're really thinking about how they can apply that to data. So can we do anything with Excel and AI together?
Yeah, you bet. So let me show you an example here of a feature called Insights. Now, I'm looking at a bunch of data here. In fact, it's a pretty sizable amount. If I go to the bottom here, it's about 4,466 rows of data.
It's quite a bit.
It's quite a bit. And so what you typically do here is start creating some pivot tables and trying to find trends in that information.
Mm-hmm.
But with a series of cloud-powered algorithms with Insights, I can simply click that Insights button, and you'll notice on the right-hand side, we're doing some analysis, we're running some heuristics on this data, and bringing back a series of suggested things you might, or trends that you may or may not have observed. So here I can see, for example, spend by fiscal month, spend by category. Ooh, marketing and people seem to be declining. I hope I joined the right team here at Contoso. So yes. I might want to take this chart and say, you know what, I want to summarize that. By the way, 28 different results. So there's quite a few more we could browse through.
Right.
But in the interest of time, I'm just going to simply take this chart. And we'll see that the intelligence in Excel has automatically created a summary pivot table and a chart that goes along with it.
It might explain why the sales have been dropping for the normal cameras.
They need to double down on my product, I think. Yeah.
Right. So we really want to help save time. What else can we do then in the context of work with AI?
So I've shown you some great examples on a PC and a desk environment or mobile environment. But when you're mobile, you're also using your phone, right? More and more today.
Right.
And so it's really important to be able to be productive on the go as well as safe on the go, because you're also more distractible when you're mobile. So I'm going to bring up my mobile phone here, and I'm going to bring up probably the application I use more than any other, which is Outlook. And in my inbox, I've got an email from Megan Bowen, and she's saying, hey, I've been looking at this Contoso Q2 sales data. It's a Power BI dashboard. I'll tap the link. And here I can see that, for example, our camera sales have been declining. Quadcopters are increasing. That's part of the business
yeah.
strategy as we've you got a mature market around cameras, and we're trying to launch a new category to get to some new customers.
Right.
I want to have a meeting with the team to be able to discuss this in more detail and how we capitalize and take advantage of it. But I don't have a personal assistant back at the office, so I'm going to use Cortana to help me schedule this meeting. You'll notice I've copied Cortana, And I'm just going to at mention Lee and add Lee to our discussion. And here you can kind of see I've said, hey, can you set up some time tomorrow for us to meet? I'm going to go ahead and send that message to Cortana. And she's going to, in the background, consult the free busy, find out when people are available, and automatically schedule this meeting for me. And sure enough, there it is. So now when I tap on the message from Cortana, we've got the right time set up. We've got a meeting that's established for us. Pretty straightforward.
It saves a lot of time, especially when you're on mobile, if you had to kind of compare everyone's schedules. So
yeah.
One of the things I noticed in your inbox is you're getting emailed already directly from the CEO of the company.
I like to make a big impact fast on a new job. But as I open this email from Patty, what you'll notice is Intelligence and Outlook is actually highlighting the fact that this email address is rather suspicious. This is not the one Patty typically uses to correspond with me, likely a phishing attack. And so I think I'm going to hold off on responding until I can investigate a little bit further.
It doesn't look too legit. Of course, we've built all of this intelligence into Office. Now, if you're a developer, you can use Azure Cognitive Services, which includes things like machine learning models, and it's all hosted as a service. It's a really great way to add valuable AI capabilities right into your apps and websites. Now, if you saw with Office, each of those cognitive services really provides AI functionality spanning vision, speech, language, knowledge, and search like we just saw. So, Jack, are all of these capabilities available now?
Most are available today or being rolled out as part of the Office Insiders builds. So sign up as an Office Insider, and if you're on Office 365 and you're an admin, you can enable targeted release in your tenant for everyone or selected users today.
And of course, if you want to see the latest updates in action, subscribe to the Mechanics channel on YouTube and follow us on Twitter. That's all the time we have for this show. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.